longitude.
You study differences of latitudes and longitudes. Who will
longitude.
Who will read?
Sir, I will.
Sir, I will.
Sir, I
will.
Sir, I
read.
Sir, I
will.
Sir, I will.
First, I will read. Ananya, read.
Charts of latitudes and longitudes. First, both the horizontal of east west of lines on the globe are called parallel of latitude. Third, any place on the earth can be located with the help of these lines. The vertical or
north-south
lines are called meridians of longitude. Five, in drawing this imaginary line, we use the north pole and the south pole as two.
Yes, then
basic of reference. 181 parallels of latitudes and 360 meridians of longitude. Time zone, there is a relationship between longitude and time as the earth rotates. Every place has it.
Okay, Nanay, okay. Leave. Now, here we can see that what are the features of latitudes and longitudes. In the previous class, what we have studied? We have studied about latitudes, what are latitudes and what are longitudes, right?
Yes, sir.
In this class, we are going to study the features of latitudes and longitudes. So, the first point says that both are imaginary lines drawn on the globe. So simple, right? We have already seen the latitude and longitude, that these are imaginary lines. These lines are not exactly drawn on the earth. These are imaginary lines which are drawn on the globe or sometimes on the map also. Okay? To locate a place, to find different times. Okay? To find a time zone of a particular place, to locate a place. These latitudes and longitudes are used. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, so the horizontal lines are called. What are the horizontal lines? You know, it moves from east to west.
East and west. Yes, sir.
What are horizontal lines called?
East or west.
What are they called?
Sir, east or west.
Latitudes, okay?
Parallel, yes, sir.
Of latitude. Horizontal line. Which are drawn from east to west, from east direction to west direction are called parallels of latitudes. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, any place on the earth can be located with the help of these lines. So, with the help of latitudes and longitudes, you can locate any place on the earth. Okay?
Okay, sir.
So, what another feature is? Another feature is place location or location of a place. With the help of latitudes and longitudes, you know, where the line is. From there you can locate the exact location of a place. Suppose you have to find the location of Gorakhpur on globe. So with the help of latitudes and longitudes, you can find the location where Gorakhpur is located. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, since the horizontal lines are called latitudes, so the vertical lines, you know, the straight lines which runs from north to south are called longitudes.
Some meridians of longitudes.
Yes. Vertical lines.
So vertical meridians
runs from north to south. Okay. What are they called? Meridians of.
Some meridians of longitudes. Yes, sir.
Error wise is not clear.
Shiv Shankar, please check your internet connection. I think there is some problematic. You are not able to find the proper voice every day. Okay, please check your internet connection. Okay. Now, Now, what is the fifth point? The fifth point says, in drawing these imaginary lines, we use the North Pole and the South Pole as two basic point of reference on the surface. I've told you now. So North Pole and South Pole are the, you know, we use it for reference. We keep North Pole and South Pole and then we draw lines. Okay.
Yes.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, the sixth point says, how many, there are 181 degrees parallels of latitudes and 360 degree meridians of longitude. So how many degrees latitude do you have? 181.
So parallels of latitude is 181 and meridians of longitude is 360.
And longitude of 360 degree.
360 degree.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
Would you have understood? So these are very important features of latitudes and longitudes. Understanding?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All I've understood now?
Yes, sir.
Ananya?
Yes.
Ananya? Okay. I think she has left.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Anubhav, any problem?
No, sir.
Ayush Adav?
No, sir.
Now we are going to study time zone. Okay. What is a time zone? Anubhav, read. Anubhav? Read time zone.
These are relationships between longitude and time. As the earth rotates, every place has its sunrise, sunset and moon, where the sun is at its highest point in the sky at its noon.
Okay. Read local time also. Anubhav, read local time also. Anubhav?
Yes, sir.
Read local time also.
Sir, your voice is not clear.
Read local time also.
Local time can be reckoned by the shadow casted by the sun, which is the shortest at noon and the longest at sunrise and sunset. When the prime meridian of Greenwich has the sun at the highest point in the sky, all the places along the meridian will have midday or noon as the earth rotates from west to east. The place east of Greenwich will be ahead of Greenwich time and those to west be behind it.
Okay. Now, so we'll study about time zone, okay? What is time zone?
Okay, sir.
Now, okay, tell me, this is what? This is suppose globe or earth, okay?
Okay, sir.
Now, so the first lines I have, when I was teaching you longitudes, I have already told now that longitudes are responsible for telling the time of a place. I told you, meridian time, GMT.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
So, you know, there is a very close relationship between longitudes and time. Okay? Longitudes are only responsible to locate a time at a place. Am I clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, that the earth rotates on its axis, true or not? The earth rotates on its axis. So, suppose in India you have time. In US, you have night time. In India right now you have daytime. In USA you are having nighttime. Okay, so the time, it changes according to the rotation of the earth. Am I clear? As the earth moves on its axis, as the earth rotates on its axis, the time also changes. At one time you have day and on the other side you have night. Am I clear? On one side of the earth and on the other side you have night. Suppose in India you are having day time. So in America you will be having night time.
Night time.
So what I so and how do you note the exact time of a place? Just because of the longitude. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
With the time changes, day and night changes, and with the longitude, you are able to get the fixed location of a place. Sorry, fixed time of a place. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Now we are going to discuss about local time. Anubhav?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Switch on a video. Now we are going to discuss about local time. Local time can be reckoned by the shadow casted by the sun, which is the shortest at noon and longest at sunrise and sunset. And how can you find local time? You can find local time by the shadow which is casted by the sun. You know, now you are, you know, parchhai aapki aati hai na, shadow. You know what is shadow?
Yes, yes, sir.
Parchhai.
Yes, yes, sir.
When you go into the sun during afternoon time, what do you find? You find the short shadow. Suppose this is your body. Behind your body, you will find shadow, right?
Yes, sir.
Suppose this is your body. Your body. So what happens? Here you will find your shadow behind your body, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Here you find your shadow. Okay. So see, when it is daytime, when it is afternoon time, okay. So the length of the shadow is short. Okay. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
When it is morning or evening or sunrise or sunset, the length of the shadow is larger. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
This shadow you can find off, you know, when it is noon time, and this long shadow you find when it is sunrise or sunset. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, when the prime meridian of Greenwich has the sun at the highest point in the sky, all the places along this meridian will have midday or noon. So what I said, you know, Greenwich meridian time is the central point. I told you, na?
Yes, sir.
GMT is the central longitude, right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So, see here. When listen very carefully. When the sun is at highest point, when the sun is at peak in GMT, okay? So the places which is you know, connected to GMT will all have midday. It will all have daytime. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
And it will have daytime and the opposite sign will have nighttime. Okay, the places connected to GMT, linked to GMT, it will have daytime and the other side will have nighttime. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, in which direction that the earth rotates? It earth rotates from west to east or east to west? You tell me.
So, west, sir.
West to east.
Yes.
The earth rotates from west to east.
West to east.
Yes. Okay. So, you know, the time. This is the Greenwich time, right? Okay.
Yes, sir.
This time, this direction. You see this direction, this direction will have a time ahead, okay, and this direction will have what it will have below time.
Yes, sir.
Below. Am I clear? This direction will have, you know, back time. Suppose, you know, if it is, you know, today is which date? 19th of April, okay.
Yes.
In India, you have 19th April. But in America, what date you will have? You'll have 18th April. Okay? America is one day behind India. Am I clear? Why it is so? It is just because of the time zones due to the rotation of the earth. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Now,
No, sir.
Now, Kavya, read standard time.
Standard time. The local time of places which are on different meridians is bound of different. This will create problems for the people. There are about 30 meridians of longitudes passing through India. That means India has 30 local time To avoid this confusion, local time of a central meridian is taken as the time from the whole country. This is called standard time. Some countries like Russia have a great longitudinal extent, and so they have adopted more than one standard time.
Okay.
India standard.
Okay. Leave. So what is standard time? You know, the local time. You know, if you see the local time of places which are on different meridians is bound to differ. This will create problems for people. Okay. Now see. Suppose a big country like India. Okay. India. So here, for India, different longitudes might be passing. Okay, kaise longitudes pass hote honge? Right?
Yes, sir.
So see, in India is a large country, so you might be having different time zones. Oh, sorry, and many longitudes you might be having for India. So create confusion. Like if you say in UP you have, suppose it is 11:30. So Rajasthan you will have 10:30. In South India you will have 11:30. You will have 11:15. Okay. So this will create confusion in one country only. That in some part of the country you have different time, and in some part of country you have different time. Right. This will create a confusion.
So
avoid this problem, one standard local time. Okay. One standard local central meridian is taken. For India, you have Indian standard time. The local meridian for India is what? Indian standard time. Okay? To avoid this confusion of time, you have one local meridian which is responsible for the time in a country. Am I clear? So our country
has Indian
standard time.
Yes, sir.
So you have the same time. Right now it is 11:30. So it is 11:30 in the entire country. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear to you? It is 11:30 the entire country. Am I clear to you?
Okay. Yes, sir.
In Pakistan, you will have different time. In India, you will have same time. Pakistan, you will have different time. If you go to China, you will have different time. So this standard time is only for India. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is local time. So for big countries like Russia, you have more than one standard meridian. There you will find different time because Russia is a very big country. Okay? And it is not possible to set the time of India with one standard meridian only. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
That is why the standard time is very important and the longitudes are very important for the to know the time of a place. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, the last thing is left Indian standard time. In India, the longitude of 82.5 degrees is considered as standard meridian, which is noon on the longitude. When it is noon on the longitude, that time is taken as noon for the whole country. This is known as Indian standard. As I've already told you,
it
has its own standard time. When it is noon on that standard time, so it is noon for the entire country. Suppose it is 11:31 right now, according to that standard meridian, so it will be 11:30 in the whole country. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
This is only Indian standard time.
Yes, sir.
That the standard, is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Ayush Yadav, is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here, what is Indian standard time? So, you know, for the entire country, you have one time zone for the entire country. Okay.
Okay.
To avoid confusion, one single time zone is created for entire country. Suppose it is 11:30 right now. So it is 11:30 in the whole country. Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is the chapter. So any problem in the chapter?
No, sir.
Okay. So what I will do, I will share you the PDF of this chapter. You will write it in your social studies copy. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So homework is, I will share you the PDF. You will write in your history copy. Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
And sir, send a Google Classroom.
Yes, send it in Google Classroom, ma'am. Okay?
Okay, sir.